All right, guys, so here is the SD Nightingale, fully painted, didn't really do anything custom to it, but fully painted SD cross silhouette Nightingale right here. So I'm just gonna go over some of the things that I did to it. You know, I already showed y'all the paints I use in the unboxing video. So shouldn't be any kind of surprise on what I did to it and what kind of paints I use. But let's just go ahead and go over a little bit of the details. All right, so first things first, just kind of like looking at the head. Didn't really do anything special, just kind of like painted for the eye. Painted it a chrome and then a clear green right over that to kind of make it a little bit more kind of like standout-ish. And then I just went ahead and put a couple water slide decals on the head. So that was about it for that. And now looking at the body, the one thing I kind of noticed that the body is a little bit brighter than like most of the rest of the body, mainly the bottom half right here, as well as the I guess the little like wings on the back. Kind of, I don't know, I don't really mind it. I don't really know how I got this to be a little bit brighter than everything else. I just kind of like painted the same coat over everything. So I mean, it's a learning experience. Maybe I just gotta be a little more attentive next time. But for the body, I can't get this part to go down all the way. I've tried many times, and this part just doesn't want to stay down all the way. So eventually, I'm gonna have to just kind of like go back, maybe take this apart and try and figure that out. But really, all I did was kind of like paint some yellow right inside there. I freehanded this crest part. Did not come out as good as I was really expecting it to come out, so kind of is what it is. It's a learning curve, so I'll go ahead and do better next time. And then these little pipings down here, I just went ahead and painted all those chrome. And now looking at the waist, basically put a little water slide decal right there, hand painted the white and the black and yellow all right there, because that was actually supposed to be originally a sticker. A couple of water slides here and there, just some chrome right here on the back, and then yeah, just the water slides, and that's about it for the waist part itself. And now looking at the legs, nothing really changed with the legs, to be honest. They're still pretty much like the same, you know, didn't really change anything to it. So a couple of water slides here and there, and that's really about it. And now we're looking at the arms. All I really did was put a little water slide decal right there. Don't think I put any other water slides. Oh, I put one kind of like right here on the forearm and right there. So that's pretty much it. Didn't really do anything. I had to mask this right here. I don't know if it's really easy to see, but I had to mask the hand, and then I just went ahead and painted the same color as everything else right there. What I really wish I would have done is probably get some extra different, like a different type of hands to replace these, because I mean, they look fine and all, but I think something that would have been a little bit better and more dynamic, at least for this one, would have made this kit just a little bit better. And looking at these like little wings as well as the little funnels. So all I did, I just kind of painted all these the same color. I did a little bit of highlighting pretty much throughout this kit. It's kind of hard to see, but I went over some of this with like clear red. So some of these parts, you can kind of see like the little reddish inside there, as well as like right here. So just a little bit clear red. And then the, chrome right here at the tips. Now I do have some clear like some clear piping, so that way I can go ahead and make all these kind of just in flight. But I think I'm gonna save this, because I have a feeling that maybe a real grade Hainu might come out in the future. So I'm gonna go ahead and save all the craziness I want to do to this kit for a diorama whenever the Hainu hopefully comes out in the future. And then I went ahead and put a couple of decals that just says funnel system right here on the front and the back. And then underneath, just putting some clear red underneath. So that's pretty much it for those. And lastly, for the weapons, I kind of bought this like little extra like builder's parts from Bandai, and it had this crest. So I went ahead and just snipped like some of the little pegs on the back of it to where it's a little bit smooth, and went ahead and cemented that right on the shield. We'll paint it and then cemented right on the shield. So pretty much, I think it looks way better than just kind of like putting a decal right there, because this does have a little bit of I don't know, like depth to it. So I think the shield looks pretty dope. The weapon, yeah, I could have done more to this. I just didn't know what really to do. Like, I don't know, like there's a couple of spots I could have painted inside, but honestly, I was just like, you know what? Keep this the same. Paint the chrome right up here, and then paint clear green right there for whatever this is. I'm sorry. Like, I don't know if it's a scope or if that was like some kind of extra like type of weapon attachment to the rifle itself. I really didn't look at the lore. But I went ahead and just painted that green because I thought that was a scope. So other than that, I mean, it was a pretty nice build overall. I do enjoy it. The one thing I will say is it's something that I want to do more of. I want to build more SDs, paint more SDs. This is the first SD Gundam I've ever painted before, so I want to actually get into the habit of it and I want to test out my skills and maybe be a little more adventurous next time. So this kit was actually a part of a contest I was doing, which was the Gunpla Network's SD Build Off. Basically what it was, you basically build an SD Gundam. It doesn't actually have to be an SD per se, but it had to be a model within the SD proportions. Big head, small body. I didn't take it, I guess, as seriously as I really should have. I kind of wanted to more experiment, and I wanted to test out these paints, test out some of my skills with my airbrush and, you know, as a new painter. So I really feel confident in my build, but there were some amazing entries in this contest. So honestly, I'm not surprised if I don't even place at all. But what I would say is that, you know, good luck to everyone and to those winners that, you know, should be getting announced fairly soon. Definitely well deserved, because I know pretty much there were like 10 solid builds. I was just like, you know, I would have a tough time judging these guys. But you know what? I love this kit either way. I think it's gonna have some great shelf presence in my my overall room. So I'm very proud of it. And you know, I cannot wait to start moving on to the other SD Gundams, especially, and yeah, I'm not gonna believe this, I cannot wait to build that SD Zaku. I just bought the paints for it, and it's one of the kits that I'm just like, I want to build and paint this almost immediately, but I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit of time, maybe a couple weeks, and then maybe when I get back from Tokyo, I think at that point I'll go ahead and I'll start on the next painted build. But other than that, guys, that's it. So definitely thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy the build overall. And if you have any kind of like remarks or any kind of critiques, definitely let me know in the comments below. Or maybe, you know, if you was gonna go ahead and paint this, what color schemes are you gonna go ahead and put yours in? But that's it for me, guys. Definitely thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.